for the duration that I've been here, the Stars have already, always made sweeping changes whenever they've missed the playoffs. Usually coaches got fired, general managers got swapped out, what have you. And now it was on to players. For a long time, the core guys around here had included Marty Turco and obviously Mike Modano for two decades. And the sense was that they needed to make a change. And, it was met with a lot of resistance and turbulence from fans. They got into the season, had a terrific start, were rolling. They were the surprise team. There were no expectations for this team. Here's another non-playoff year. They just said goodbye to Turco and Modano. There's no way they're making the playoffs. And I remember after that, they'd won their eighth game in a row. They were within 4 points of first, or had a chance to move within 4 points of first overall in the National Hockey League. And then they just got clobbered. And that's where the season just sort of unraveled. And find themselves now the team that's ninth or tenth in the conference with four games to go and having to win every game. With all that said, they sit here on the cusp of their final four games. They're 3 points out of a playoff spot. All they have to do is win four games in a row. If they win all four and they get to 97 points, they'll make the playoffs. I don't think Calgary can get in. Chicago's going to get exhausted at some point, you would think. That's the team, I said for a month now, that's the team they have to beat out to make the playoffs. Anaheim also, they're teetering on the cut line. I think it's going to end up coming down to the Dallas Stars, defending Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks, and it'll probably come down to that game on Sunday in Minnesota, and it might go beyond 60 minutes to see who gets into the playoffs.
Score goals.
Is that it?
Play defense.
How does our chance to get playoffs? Goals.
Gotta win out.
The Stars didn't score on that second power play and seemed to lose a little bit of their momentum there. Kari had a good period. They had a very determined checking period. Stars have to be thankful that they're up after one, the way that period ended. They'll get better as this moves along. They got through those two power plays, or most of it anyway. I think that was big.
Do you think they're going to make the playoffs this year?
I would hope they would, but I don't think they're
better for you if they make it, huh?
Yeah, because then I'm not going to have any more work.
Go Stars.
Are the Stars going to make the playoffs? Of course they're going to make the playoffs. What are you talking about?
Matt Jones to block that.
Off the line.
Really going at it. And Goldberg.
this is the first four in a row to put us in.
How about still that? Alive, and we just got to hope that some teams lose.
That's true.
Good news. Adam Burrish, inspirational leader for the Stars, back tonight to join Mike Ribeiro and the Stars' quest to get into the playoffs. They have to win three straight. Their three remaining games and need to get some help. With Chicago losing to Detroit in one of their two final games, it could come elsewhere as well. Three games left. Playoffs are still a possibility, but it begins with a win tonight. Tip it right to Wandell. Ducked under Porter's check. Little space back of the net, wrapping around. Loose, he scores! Tom Wandell makes it 1-0 Dallas. Sort of between Ben and Richards. And now Ben, no respect, gave it to Erickson, he scores! Jamie Benn bashes over Milan Hayduk, and Louis Erickson makes it 2-0. Again, the story, Dallas trying to keep their playoff hopes alive. A regulation loss by the Stars, Nashville, Phoenix, and Anaheim would all clinch tonight and put Dallas on the very brink. But a win tonight and a win out, and they need just a little bit of help. Macias to Dupuis. Duchesne standing in front of the net. Dupuis smoked back of the goal, but he gets it in front for a shot. They score! Brandon Yip makes it 2-1. And all that hard work and all that hitting and all that who cares has paid off for Colorado.
Final home game of the regular season. Stars up on the Avalanche. 2-1 in our second
period. Well, it's a second period here, end of second period. We're watching the Stars and the Avalanche, and Stars are a 2-1 game going into the third period. The Stars really have to be physical, don't sit back on their heels, and start attacking a little bit better. But I think everybody here in Dallas really believes that the Stars can come in and make it to the playoffs.
To the limit here in the third period and do it in regulation.
They stay in the race. Still time. Game 82 may be meaningful. Post-game show's coming up next. Seconds to go. Thrown to the net. Blocked away by Jimmy Howard. Half board playing right in front. It ricocheted off the outside of the cage by Kopetsky. 4 seconds to go. To the corner. Trying to dig it out. Kopetsky. How close did it come to a chance? And the Blackhawks will have to wait until later.
Will the team with the Warriors head on the front and the Tomahawks on the side be back? Dallas and Minnesota, 6 p.m. Eastern on the NHL Network.
The 2010-11 NHL season, the league's comeback kids have their shot. The Stars set the tone in their very first game. No hill would be too steep, and they would not be going away. And they haven't. And now, they have their shot as they come to the franchise's birthplace, knowing that a playoff spot is theirs with a win. XL Energy Center in St. Paul, Minnesota gets quite a jolt. The state of hockey will see a very meaningful hockey game. The Dallas Stars have held their gun to the Chicago Blackhawks' heads all week. And finally, they have a chance to pull the trigger. The Stars in game 82 can clinch a playoff spot tonight. Tonight, this is true. Win and you're in. Face-off specialist as well. Steve Ott goes to work and rips it away from Matt Cullen. And we're underway. Dallas Stars try and finish it tonight. Burns at the line. Shot it, tipped, loose in front, backhand shot, score! Wilder on the board first, Stein. Richards off to Erickson, got it back, he scores! Brad Richards ties the game at 1, 7.5 minutes into the first period. The power play, Erickson shot, score! Power play goal for Louis Erickson, 2-1 Dallas.
First period for Dallas.
Got a break earlier in the day when Chicago lost at home to the Detroit Red Wings. That means if the Stars win tonight in regulation or overtime, the Dallas Stars are in and the defending Stanley Cup champion Hawks are out. The Stars, with goals by Brad Richards and Louis Erickson, lead 1-0 after 20 minutes in St. Paul. Brunette back of the net. Spurgeon scores, game is tied, power play goal for the Wild.
Here we have it, Sag.
Bronziak spinning loose for Gillies, 3-2 Minnesota. Down low to Erickson, because I have the puck. Stoner, Burns, and Koivu on the kill. Goligoski shot, score! Alex Goligoski ties the game at 3 and they stay on the job.
Stars up. If they're up after 65 minutes in this one, they'll play the Vancouver Canucks in the opening round of the Stanley Cup.
Koivu deep, Brunette in front, Mietinen scores. And the former Star scores a huge goal to put a dent in their postseason lives. It's 4-3 in the front. In front, he shoots, it's loose. They claw away at it. The Wild put up a gauntlet and it's under there somewhere. .331 to play in the third. Theodore keeps it 4-3 Minnesota. Cleared pass, Goligoski. Locks up, Bouchard shot it. And the Dallas Stars season will end in Minnesota.